Today, we are going to talk about how to compute the bulk modulus of a material. And the material we're going to calculate is the diamond structure of carbon. And you can find this tutorial PDF on my website. And I'm also going to go through this tutorial in detail. So first of all, I'm going to create the input file for ABINIT. And ABINIT is a DFT software. It's a plain wave based DFT program. And the input file I'm going to create is g.in. And ABINIT has no restriction for the input file name. So you can give any name for the input file. So this is the pre-made input file for my simulation. I'm going to perform the PAW calculation. So you can see that I have an extra keyword to define a fine mesh for the PAW simulations. And this is the E-cut for the soft part of the orbitals. And the number of atoms is 2, so the N atom is 2. And I have only one carbon element in this material, in this bulk, so the nuclear charge is 6. The number of the type of the atoms is 1, and the type of the atom is 1, 1, because I'm going to have 2 atoms in this simulation cell. And this is the key point mesh I defined for this carbon diamond structure. Because it is an insulating material, so we don't need a very high key point mesh. I just do 8 by 8 by 8. And I also do not perform any shift of the key point mesh. So I just perform one key point mesh shift, and the shift is 0, 0, 0. So this is going to give me a non-shifted key point mesh. And Ix equal to 11, so that's the PBE exchange correlation functional. ABINIT is very convenient for scanning some parameters in your simulation. So here I use the NTD set equal to 10 to scan, to perform 10 different Kongsham DFT simulations with different lattice parameters. So this A cell, so this keyword define the beginning lattice parameter we are going to scan. And this is the increment of the lattice parameter. And this define the 3 lattice vectors A, B, and C for the cell. And here define the 2 atoms in the reduced coordinate for this simulation. After that, we need to download the PAW data file for carbon. You can just go to the GBRV website and to download the PAW potential for carbon. You go to the periodic table, you click carbon, and you choose the one for ABINIT. You right click it on it and get the menu, copy the link, and go back to the console and do wget and the address. It's going to download the PAW data file for you. You can see that now we have this data file here. Then you copy this file name into the g.files file and put it here. Okay, so this is my job submission file I created to run this job. You can see that I'm going to use 32 cores to run the ABINIT program. And so let's do this. I do sbatch job.s. So I can monitor the progress of the calculation by tail the g.out file. Okay, so the job finished. The job is very fast because we have only 2 atoms in the simulation box. It's a very tiny system. And also we only have a 8 by 8 by 8 key point mesh, which is not very large. Next, we are going to fit the energy versus the volume. So we got the energy first, So you can grab it from the t.out file, which is here. You copy and paste these numbers into MATLAB. By the way, so this MATLAB script has been given in the PDF. If you scroll all the way down to the second page, you will see that, the third page. So this is the script you can use to do the fitting. So basically speaking, you are going to fit the energy and the volume into this equation to get the bulk modulus, which is B0 here. After getting the energy, we are going to get the volume. So you grab UC vol equal sign. So that's the volume. Copy and paste. So press F5 on my keyboard to run this script. Okay. You can see that this is the fitting of the energy versus the volume. And the bulk modulus is given here. So we get 227 gigapascal, and which compared pretty well with the experimental measurement, which is 442 gigapascal in the table 4 of this paper. So hope you like this video and find it useful for your DFT simulations. Bye-bye.